snow. I have carved out this soul made of stone, and I will drag.
Hello everyone, and welcome to Fury Episode 11! It has been 3 years since the last Fury, and we're on Mondays now, V-Pac.
Yeah, well, it's great to have Fury back, and it's great to be a part of it.
Historic 11th episode of Fury.
Do you smell what the smoke is cooking?
Oh no!
The smoke?
I forgot we hired him.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the general manager of Monday Night Fury, The Smoke!
There you hear it there, V-Pac, the general manager.
Why does he look like Ace Ventura?
Why is he ripping off The Rock?
Well, in that suit, it looks like something Ace Ventura would wear.
Ace Ventura would wear an alligator skin suit that he got from the Salvation Army?
Probably. But seriously, so this guy's the GM of Fury, huh?
Yes, he is. Don't ask me why we hired him.
Yeah, I think Dwayne Johnson wants his gimmick back.
And his theme song.
And his gate.
And his crown, apparently.
Alright, let's see.
Finally, the smoke has graced your presence. Here in Cincinnati, this rudy poo trash of town. Here's something about the people of Cincinnati that the smoke needs to get off his chest. The people of Cincinnati do not understand the meaning of hygiene. They stink, they sit by the river, and they smell like fish. But the smoke is not out here to talk about you pieces of garbage. The smoke is out here to talk about the fact that finally the smoke has been hired to be the general manager of Monday Night Fury.
Don't remind me.
That's right. Hold your applause.
Does he know Ohio's not near any body of water?
After the show, if you want to smoke, has a nice room in the back. It's got a lot of cocktails, a lot of pie, a whole lot of pie. Smoke loves his pie. But that's beside the point. The smoke is here to talk about one thing and one thing only, and that is Eastern Invasion.
Actually, it's off the Cincinnati's up by the Hawaiian.
TPGW will have its best compete live from Tokyo, Japan, at Eastern Invasion. And the smoke says it's time to make a world championship main event. Now, following the events of Hawaiian Beach Bash, the smoke believes that the true number one contender is Rex Titus. So, Daniel Stone will defend the world title at Eastern Invasion against the two-time TPWF champion, Rex Titus.
Oh!
And on that note, the smoke has to point out the Euro-American Championship situation. A lot of people believe it was controversial how Josh Gunner won his Euro-American Championship, so he will defend against Landry at Eastern Invasion.
Oh!
But while we're on the subject of that loony boo redneck piece of garbage, the smoke has to mention the fact that there will be a new number one contender after Eastern Invasion, and it will be decided in a best of five. The former Euro-American champion, Andrew Tanaka, will take on the former hardcore champion, Matt Farrow. And that's all the smoke has to say about that.
Well, that's impressive, a best of five.
Now then, if you'll excuse the smoke, he's got business to do. And by the way, you folks still smell like fish. If you smell what the smoke is.
Uh-oh! Speaking of that best of five, here's one of the people in the V-Pac.
I was about to say that this guy looks like a goofball, but at least he's got some nice ideas for some matches. And now here comes Matt Farrell.
I wonder what he's going to have to say to our new general manager, especially after what happened at Beach Bash. V-Pac, you remember.
Exactly. Matt Farrell threw it into the Hardcore Championship. Fights the DCA Celestial Champion, Malik Brown.
Matt Farrell.
And yeah, obviously Matt Farrell is not in a good mood here tonight.
If I were the smoke, I'd be careful.
Maybe we'll get lucky and they'll knock those disgusting sideburns off his face.
I'm going to give you a warning. If your rip-off rock ass does not get out of this ring, does not get out of my ring in the next 5 minutes, I guarantee you that your shit-eating grin will no longer be seen by these fans because you will have swallowed your teeth. Do I make myself clear? Oh, geez. The HKK chants filling the arena.
Yeah, if I was Smoke, I'd get out of there right now.
Smoke reluctantly leaving. Let's not forget he is the management around here, unfortunately.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Beach Bash happened. You know? Not mad. Motivated because now I'm in a best of five with Tanaka to fight the Euro-American champion. I'm motivated because Josh Gunner is the Euro-American champion, and I know I can kick his blue bleeding asshole.
Oh.
And I'm motivated because Malik Brown fucked up. Now, I won't stop until everything Malik Brown loves and treasures is taken away. Malik, you seem surprised that I called you out. Dude, you're the man in DCA practically. You defend that title every damn match you're in. And you're surprised that up-and-coming talent want to call you out? Yeah, I'm sick of DCA taking priority over TPGW. This is my home. Say what you want about Rex Tyus. Say what you want about Duncan Vermeil, Kevin Cash, even CJ fucking Hawkins. This is the house that Matt Farrow built. Malik Brown, you entered my turf and cost me the championship I defined. Now, I'm going to take everything you care about from you. And why? Because that's what the NIS does. So I've decided I will be poison to Malik Brown. If Danny Gibbons is a monarch, I'll show her what a king can do. I'll show Tyson Jax what a real monster is. And strip Smokey of his manhood so he can't have those hillbilly nights with Trish anymore, if you know what I'm saying.
Oh, God.
At Caw All-Stars, Malik, I'm going to kick your ass. I'm going to kick your ass unsanctioned style, because this isn't about nicknames. This isn't about catchphrases. This isn't about titles. This is about a fight. And I'll see you on Takedown.
Whoa! Are you freaking kidding me?
Matt Farrell threatening to show up on DCA Takedown and take the fight to Malik Brown.
I don't know if he's either got the biggest set of balls ever, or he's got a death wish.
We'll take on the entire NIS is foolish, but coming up next, it's tag team action. The tag champs are going to take on the Chaos Flame. We are live from Cincinnati, Ohio.
Tag team contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Boston, Massachusetts, at a combined weight of 502 pounds, they are the TPGW Tag Team Champions, Johnny Mike, and Stray Meeks.
About to say the tag team champions, Johnny Mike and Stray Meeks, set for action here tonight after a successful title defense at Beach Bash.
Yeah, very shocking that these two were able to capture lightning in a bottle yet again and defeat Mortifera.
The only question is now, V-Pac, who are going to be the new number one contenders?
Well, that is a big question. There you see Stray Meeks. Yes, finally, I got his name right. That's Johnny Mike, right?
Yep.
Okay, good. Finally starting to remember people's names around here.
Nonetheless, the tag team champions are going to be set for action here tonight. It's going to be a very tough challenge for them here tonight against a new tag team that's going to be looking to become the number one contenders. And one of them is a former United States champion from the old TPWF days. Their opponents in a combined weight of 434 pounds. Ryan Slender and Shannon Hunter, the Chaos Flame! V-Pac, I think this is your first time ever seeing members of the Chaos Flame in action.
There's more than these two guys?
No, it's just these two, but...
Okay. So, this is... So, who's who?
Well, the shorter one is Ryan Slender, the former TPWF United States Champion. His partner, Shannon Hunter, is a rookie here in TPGW.
Alright, so I'm guessing Shannon Hunter is the guy with the face paint?
He's the guy with the face paint.
Okay. That's Shannon Hunter, and Ryan Slade is the guy with the...
Ryan Slender.
Slender.
Like Slenderman.
Okay, ugh. Don't even remind me of that thing.
Actually, that's where he took his name. That's where he got his name from.
Oh, he's all right. I already don't like this guy.
Nonetheless, Johnny Mike going to work on Ryan Slender. Oh, that knee in the corner. Oh, a quick one-handed face buster. Now look at this dragon sleeper.
Right. Come on, Johnny. Don't let Slenderman over here beat you. Ugh. Just thinking about Slenderman creeps me out.
See, I didn't find that game all that scary. It was just boring. Ryan Slender. Oh, with a complete shot.
And now, yep, there's a tag. Here comes
Shannon Hunter.
Shannon Hunter. Okay, I'm going to call him Ryan Hunter. Shannon Hunter in there with Johnny Mike.
Oh, look at this. Ow! A huge kick as Johnny Mike points to the crowd. These fans firmly behind the tag team champions tonight. Oh, and there's a flapjack. V-Pac, what are your opinions of the Chaos Flame right now?
What are my opinions of the Chaos Flame? Well, other than the fact that Slender over here got his name from Slenderman, still gives me the heebie-jeebies just thinking about it. They seem to be a very cohesive team here.
There's a tag from. Tagging Slender in.
In there with Stray Meeks.
Stray Meeks, definitely the bigger of the two, using his power to his advantage early on. And look at this.
He's definitely the biggest guy in this matchup. Oh, and it's a huge clothesline, and there goes Slenderman.
But nonetheless, you can't judge Stray Meeks based on his size. Referee trying to hold him back right now. No, no. Oh!
Huge fall away slam there by Meeks.
The Irish whip into the corner.
Oh, look at that. Nice counter there. Tag is made. Tag champs now. The most overused move in tag team virtual wrestling. The drop toe hold and the elbow drop.
Looks like they're looking to capitalize, but uh-oh. Ryan Slender, the reversal with the German. Don't get me...
I'll admit, that was a perfect... That was a good German suplex.
And don't underestimate Ryan Slender just because of his name. Like I say, he's a former United States champion back in the old TPWF days. He was the first guy to win it.
Well, that was then and this is now. Let's see how well he does here now in tag team action.
Indeed. Slender hasn't been having all that of a successful year so far as Johnny Mike goes to the outside. He's going to be looking to turn that around, though. Maybe become number one contender.
Here? I guess he changed his mind. I thought he was going for some kind of springboard move. But Slender caught him with that fireman's carry.
Now the Irish whip off the counter. Oh! Huge knee of the gut right there.
And now... Nope.
Counter after counter. These two playing off each other pretty well right now. Uh-oh. That may end. Oh! Really?
Slender. Is it Ryan Slender?
It's Ryan Slender.
Ryan Slender. Okay, good. Ryan Slender.
Uh-oh. What's looking to do now, V-Pac? I think. Oh!
Oh, wow. Off the top row with a twist of fate.
He calls that move the high. He calls that move the high cutter.
The high cutter.
Yep. It's Ryan Slender. I think he's looking to measure his opponent. And just banging down the head. This could be very bad. Uh-oh.
Yep. Gotta say it. We got a bleeder!
Johnny Mike busted open, but back in the fight already. With the Irish whip.
Sent into the corner.
Johnny Mike springboard. Insecurity.
Shades of the current UCWL champion, the Green Arrow.
What's he looking for now? The Irish whip. I think they're going to be looking for the end-all, be-all.
Is that what they actually call their move, the end-all, be-all?
Well, you look at it and you tell me. Ow! There it is, the end-all, be-all. With the cover one.
Do it, one.
No!
Do it, no.
Shannon Hunter.
Shannon Hunter. Interrupting the count, he got any pace for it. And look at this, going right back into the cover. I have to admit, that was very smart move there on the part of Stray Meeks to quickly take out Hunter and then go back to Ryan Slender.
Indeed. And Stray Meeks, he's not wasting any time. And uh-oh.
What is this?
Oh,
snake eyes in the corner.
With the Irish whip now. Oh!
Short arm shoulder block there by Stray Meeks. And now Meeks off the second rope. Missing the elbow.
Like I've always said about Stray Meeks, you can't judge him by his size. He's extremely agile in that ring.
He most certainly is. Tag is made to Johnny Mike, though. And look at that! Johnny Mike being used as a javelin, almost. Taking down Ryan Slender.
Indeed, you want to talk about two guys who play to their strengths? Johnny Mike and Stray Meeks? There's a reason they're the tag team champions right now.
Meeks with Ryan Slender. What's this? Oh, God! Look at that.
The reversal into the DDT.
And now, Wyatt Slender.
Slender is back on the attack.
Oof. At least he was. Oh! Roaring forearm. Roaring elbow.
Slender kicks out. Shane Hunter tried to break it up. And Hunter's going after Stray Meeks now.
Dog, ref. Get in there and do your job.
Nonetheless, Stray Meeks, I think he's taking out the competition right now.
Kick to the midsection.
Ow!
Oh, no!
Now
Shane Hunter countering with the Northern Light suplex.
Now Ryan Slender, Michinoku Driver. That's vintage Slender right there.
But there you see Speaks quickly rolling to the outside, but he's caught with a DDT, and he's going to owe Jason Collins 5 cents after that.
Yes, he is. Oh! Look at this. A short arm shoulder block. Stray Meeks. Uh-oh.
What up? Kick is blocked. Dragon Screw leg whip.
Ryan Slender. Uh-oh. There's the reversal. And another shoulder block. And now the tag to Johnny Mike.
Johnny Mike now, illegal man. What's he gonna do? Hopefully does something to Slender.
Ryan Slender showing his resiliency, and Johnny Mike off the ropes. Oh, with the knee!
Huge D right to the face there.
Oh, and the penalty kick now.
And the cover.
One, two, and no!
Again, Ryan Slender able to kick out the count of two. Oh, boy. But Johnny Mike may be signaling for something here.
Got him
out of the way. Sit down, powerbomb. The
one.
Cover. Two. No.
Wait a minute.
Hey, what the?
Johnny Mike just took out the.
What happened?
He just took out the referee. Oh, God. Johnny Mike. He's got a chair.
Are you kidding me?
Ow!
I expected better from these two men.
Do whatever it takes for the champions, I guess, but Ryan Slender definitely got rocked there. Oh!
And look at that, though. Shannon Hunter countered. Sent to the corner. Tag is made.
They're looking for the chaotic combo. Brainbuster. And the frog splash. One.
Two. Oh, no. Only one count.
I can't believe it. Johnny Mike kicking out at one. I still can't believe the tag champ for Zorin just such dirty tactics. Oh, speaking of which.
Oh, man. Did you see the way Shannon Hunter landed?
Oh!
He landed on top of Johnny Mike.
Indeed, that may have hurt Johnny Mike more than did Shannon Hunter. As Shannon now going right to work on one half of the tag team champions. This has been an absolute war between these two teams right now, V-Pac.
It most certainly has.
Makes me wish Zahaya didn't sleep this one out. He would have loved this tag team action. And Shannon Hunter now.
On the second rope.
Wow, with the drop kick and the kip off. Shannon Hunter, impressive. Oh! Dodging the rocket kick there. And a counter from Shannon Hunter as well. Oh! It looks like Shannon Hunter is Johnny Mike's number right now, V-Pac.
Most certainly does.
No, look at this. With those stomps in the corner, and now Ryan Slender tags in. The Chaos Flame getting chaotic here.
Oh man, look at this.
Uh-oh.
And now Ryan Slender.
Drop kick in the corner. Johnny Mike may be done. With the cover. And no, kick out at one.
What a match this has been between these two men. All for the number one contendership.
I mean, no! And there's a Canadian destroyer right off the bat. Oh no. Trying to take out Shane Hunter, but Hunter with the quick reversal.
Yeah. Yeah, dude, if the Chaos Flame does knock off Meeks and Mike here, they do become the number one contenders, right?
I would certainly believe so.
All right, so there we go. That's what I was trying to talk about earlier. Anyway, oh God, Slender!
Coming for the German, and the tag to the fresher Shannon Hunter.
Look at that, Hunter now with that. Hunter's going to the top. What's he got planned here?
He's got something big planned. He's measuring his man. Off the ropes, no! Dodging the drop kick there.
Missing the missile drop kick. And now, tag is made, Spray Meeks is back in.
There's that combo.
That combination of the neck whip and the spinal tap, kick to the spine.
And uh-oh.
And now, Great. Shannon Hunter.
Shannon Hunter's in trouble. Jackknife!
Jackknife powerbomb.
And there's a tag, this time, to Johnny Mike. Ow! Breaking the back there.
And now Mike, sending Hunter to the corner.
All it took was one big shot from the big man, and suddenly this match is, oh no. Oh!
And now, what's Mike got planned here? Oh, nice heel kick.
Taking out Ryan Slender. Johnny Mike tagged to Stray Meeks. Meeks now. I think he's looking for the Stray Clash.
He may be measuring him for it. Or not.
Oh, the clothesline.
Thunderous clothesline. He better do it while he can. I was about to see Slender is down still. Yeah, it's looking at what?
Straight clash!
Oh!
And just like that, the tag team champions are successful here tonight on Fury.
Well, Chaos Flame brought their A game, but it was too much for them to handle. So much for that possible future number one contendership.
Indeed. They put one heck of an effort forward. I believe they are future tag team champions, just not in the immediate future.
Tonight
it was all about the tag team champions continuing their reign of dominance here in the TPGW tag team division. Here are your winners, Johnny Mike and Stray Meeks. A huge victory for the tag team champions. And wait a minute, V-Pac!
Oh, what is this?
They have a rematch clause. I almost forgot. It's time to get funky on Fury.
Who's got a rematch clause?
The only ones who have never gotten a rematch for the tag team championships. It's Marcus and DJ. The Funk. I think we just found out who the number one contenders are. V-Pac, it's time to get funky on Fury!
I don't dance.
The former tag team champions lost their titles to Mort Vera and never took their rematch. They're taking it now, though. Look at that, Johnny Mike and Stray Mix getting out of Dodge. I think we got our tag team championship match for Eastern Invasion.
Why are we in for Eastern Invasion?
That's a good question, but something tells me Mike and Stray aren't going to have any of it tonight. And nonetheless, we are live from Cincinnati, Ohio for Friday Night Fury. And coming up next to champion versus champion match.
Oh, look, it's Tommy Ventura. And he's going one-on-one with Josh Gunner. This ought to be interesting.
Kevin Cash in a controversial fashion at Hawaiian Beach Bash.
Yeah, I know. Him and his new friggin' attitude.
You notice Holly Harris isn't with him this time. Supposedly, he's fired her as a manager.
First smart thing he's done since I met him.
Now, here comes the new Euro-American champion. And his opponent from Lexington, Kentucky, weighing in at 250 pounds, he is the TPGW Euro-American champion, Josh Gunner!
Alright, so I've seen Josh Gunner a couple of times down here in TPGW. He's definitely an impressive talent. And hopefully he's not one to take to shut Tommy Ventura up.
Well, he won the Euro-American Championship at Hawaiian Beach Bash, so that doesn't tell you what he's capable of. And he won in a Fatal 4-Way, let's not forget. Of course, Josh Gunner will be defending the Euro-American Championship. Against Landkrieg at Eastern Invasion. As said by General Manager Smoke. Right now, it's all about champion versus champion action. Who is more dominant, Tommy Ventura versus Josh Gunner? Here we go! Now the lockup, Tommy Ventura and Josh Gunner going right at it. Whoa! Josh Gunner. This is, Tommy Ventura, the reversal with the hammer lock. Now working on the arm. Tommy Ventura, Josh Gunner, the reversal into the Fujiwara arm bar, trying to out-wrestle Tommy Ventura. And Ventura flips out of it.
Well, this is definitely gonna be a technical masterpiece. I have to admit, though.
Indeed, Josh Gunner.
I may not like Tommy Ventura's new attitude, but I'm not taking away his skills in the ring.
And oh, Josh Gunner going right to work. Indeed, Josh Gunner's no pushover either. He's had some classic bouts already here in TPGW, despite this being his rookie year.
Not to mention the fact the guy is built like the late Dr. Death Steve Williams.
And he's the current Euro-American champion.
That too.
First time Ventura, the Triple Crown champion now. Both these men winning their titles at Hawaiian Beach Bash. So we'll find out whose momentum is with them more. And, oh, Time Ventura with the double stomp. This is just going to be a classic technical bout right here, V-Pac. It's Time Ventura.
It most certainly is. Let's just hope we don't have to hear from Ventura if he wins. God forbid.
Time Ventura going up to the top rope. With an elbow drop. Josh Gunner's in trouble, V-Pac.
Well, right now he is. But not anymore.
Oh, standing cutter from Josh Gunner.
Almost a variation of the Gunner Stunner.
Not quite, though. As Josh Gunner going up to the top, going up to the second rope now. He's going to be looking for something here.
He's measuring Tommy Ventura.
Oh, and kicks him down again. And off the ropes. Oh!
Huge splash to the back of Tommy Ventura.
And Tommy, though, straightjacket German. Whipping him over almost instantly. That'll give you some whiplash.
Yeah. I got to admit, even though his ego has gone up since he got rid of Holly Harris, he seems to be more focused in the ring now, though.
You say that now, but after he fired Holly Harris, I actually talked to him backstage. Tommy Ventura said it's something along the lines of, I made the Triple Crown Championship great. This is my moment. All of you will pay to see me now. Blah, 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 blah.
Oh, God.
So, in other words, he's become even more egotistical since winning. There's a reason he's talking with a country accent now.
Why?
I don't know. But look at this, Josh Gunner with the hip attack, giving him a fuel goal of that Gunner heritage. Is Josh Gunner?
Maybe that hip attack will knock some sense into Tommy Ventura, and he'll stop speaking with a country accent. Goofball.
Look at this. Josh Gunner wasn't able to hit the Gunner Stunner, but still working on Tommy Ventura here. Whoa!
Yeah. More elbows to the head, Gunner. Come on.
Oh! How about that one? Josh Gunner. Whoa!
Now that's impressive for a guy the size of Josh Gunner.
A 250-pounder with a standing dropkick, and Josh Gunner going right to work on Tommy Ventura. And whoa, there's the power!
Look at this.
Oh!
Damn it, you should have thrown him in the crowd like Bam Bam Bigelow did Spike Dudley.
Uh-oh, the Ventura with the counter. Josh Gunner with the jawbreaker reversal. This has been a back-and-forth contest here, V-Pac.
I gotta admit, it certainly has been.
And I think this has been one of the most impressive back-and-forth bouts I've ever seen. Josh Gunner taking it to the Triple Crown champion as he goes for the cover. One, two, and no.
Nice kick out there from Ventura. But come on, Gunner. More blows to the head. Knock some sense into him.
And uh-oh, look at this! Sit-up powerbomb from the pump handle.
All right, that was impressive. I'll give him that.
Tommy Ventura's attitude may be a bit wonky as of late, but nonetheless, he's impressive in the ring as Josh Gunner going right to work, working the ground game right now. Oh, and the elbow to the back of the head. Now
what's that? Gunner, what is this?
Josh Gunner, he's got something in mind.
He could be going for the most overused move in virtual wrestling, MTB.
The superplex! Yes.
The superplex, right on to Tommy Ventura.
With an uppercut. And still back and forth between these two. Josh Gunner with another standing cutter.
It looks like that may have taken something out of him too.
Just draping his arm over Ventura. One, two, and no.
And only a two count.
But Gunner.
Oh boy, Josh Gunner.
Is he gonna hit it?
Over the Gunner Stunner, he got it!
Gunner Stunner to Tommy Ventura.
That's it.
And the cover from the Euro-American Champion too, and holy hey hell, how close was that?
That was close.
Ventura with a quick uppercut.
Oh, look at this. Gunner's back in control. Yes, knock some more sense into him. You are not from the country.
Technically, he's from Norfolk, California, and some of them are a little bit country there. But it's too close to LA to really be country.
Exactly.
But Josh Gunner, uh-oh. Tommy Ventura reversing the suplex into one of his own. V-Pac, this has been a truly classic technical bout between Gunner and Ventura, if I have to say so myself.
Most certainly, I will admit, it most certainly has it. Look at this. Oh!
A running power slam. Shades of the British Bulldog, but Ty Ventura still reversing. Oh!
Oh, God, we got a bleeder.
Josh Gunner busted open from that knee. And the jawbreaker.
Yeah,
Gunner Stunner!
Gunner Stunner. That's it. Hit him.
One, two, no!
And again, somehow, some way, this goofball kicked out again.
Ty Ventura kicking Gunner off. I think Ventura's fired up.
Yeah, well, he's about to pay for it. Because Josh Gunner's back up. And instead of capitalizing, he's taunting the fans.
But look at this. The uppercut barrage from Tommy Ventura begins. And there's another. Tommy Ventura with another uppercut. And off the ropes with the drop kick. Crossface.
Oh, God.
Crossface.
Crossface on Josh Gunner. And Gunner's in the middle of the ring with nowhere to go.
Will this be it for Josh Gunner? Ty Ventura's got locked in tight. Wait, no!
Gunner using his superior upper body strength to escape out of that hole.
Oh!
There's a gut buster.
Good God, what a battle between these two. Ty Ventura, he's far from finishing another uppercut. Tommy, snap suplex, into the cover. One, two, no!
And again, Josh Gunner proves just how tough he is.
Josh Gunner, Tommy Ventura, the reversal. Oh, another shot to the shoulder, maybe weakening for another crossface. Oh! A Gunner trying to get back into this.
Big Gunner.
Kick to the gut. Josh Gunner.
What's this?
Oh!
That will definitely knock some sense into him.
And now, Josh Gunner.
Second rope.
No!
Got him.
Look at this, I think Tommy Ventura's hurt.
There you see the ref checking on him.
Look at Gunner.
A little showboating there from Gunner. I'm not sure if that's smart.
May not be smart, but Josh Gunner is in full control right now. Oh, shot to the shoulder. Uh-oh. Not sure
what. Tommy Ventura blocks it. There's the elbow.
Josh Gunner with the reversal as well. And uh-oh. Into the victory roll.
One. Two and no. Gotta admit, this has been a hell of a match between these two, and this is only what? The second match of the night?
Indeed. This is what a win. Uh-oh. Tommy Ventura. Powerbomb.
Uh-oh. Are we gonna see it? Are we gonna see it? MCB.
One, two. And there it is, the most overused move in DCA. The powerbomb into the Boston Crab.
Is Tommy Ventura going to make Josh Gunner tap out here?
No, wait!
No, he's not!
Josh Gunner surviving the Boston Crab. And how much does he have left, V-Pac? How much do either of these guys have left?
Who knows?
Ventura! Off the ropes with the forearm! Gunner trying to avoid him. Look at this, Tommy Ventura sending him into the corner. Wait, Gunner! The one and only!
Cobra clutch slam there.
One and only shades of Billy Gunn. Tommy Ventura the reversal with an uppercut. And the belly to belly.
Overhead belly to belly suplex there by Tommy Ventura.
These two have hit each other with their best moves and they're still swinging, V-Pac. Oh, look at this, Tommy Ventura, German suplex. And Ventura now. One, two, and no.
Again, Josh Gunner able to kick out. And there you see the frustration starting to come out of Tommy Ventura.
But Gunner's far from finished as well. Shot to the back. Uh-oh. Tommy Ventura with the reversal. Oh, with the arm again. Shot to the back. And what's he looking to do now? Tommy Ventura. Oh!
Back suplex into a neck breaker.
A neck breaker!
I'm not doing it.
Ventura, shoulder block. All these shots to the shoulder. And oh no, the crossface!
Again with the crossface.
Will this be it for Josh Gunner? Tommy Ventura's got it locked in tight. And Josh Gunner taps out.
Oh, damn it.
Tommy Ventura and Josh Gunner threw everything at each other in this match.
They most certainly did. I thought for sure Josh Gunner had this match won several occasions. But nonetheless,
nothing can be taken away from Josh Gunner. The only reason he probably tapped was to keep him, his arm from being ripped out of its socket.
That's true.
At the end of the day, though, Tommy Ventura locking in that crossface, and the Euro-American champion forced to tap out to the Triple Crown champion here in this champion versus champion match. Here is your winner by submission, Tommy Ventura! One of the best submission experts we've got, Tommy Ventura. It's no shame at all to tap out to him.
He's still a goofball, though, for thinking he's cutthroat.
we are live from Cincinnati, Ohio. I've been sure of picking up a huge win. Oh God, Rex Titus!
Oh. The hell is going on? Who is that?
That's Rex Titus attacking Tony Gordon!
Why the hell is he attacking Tony Gordon for?
Let's not forget that these two fought at Hawaiian Beach Bash for the world title. Daniel Stone retained in that fatal four-way. Rex Titus clearly taking out his frustration, but Tony Gordon's supposed to team with Daniel Stone tonight in our main event. Oh!
Oh, man. This is not good, MTV.
Rex Titus is the new number one contender for the world championship. Obviously, he wants to weaken Daniel Stone, so he's taking out Daniel Stone's partner. Oh, God. Tony Gordon in trouble right now, V-Pac. No!
God, just slamming him right into the locker room door. And now, oh, come on. Enough of this. Enough!
Rex Titus, he's calling himself the American Nightmare. Daniel Stone's Nightmare.
Yeah, I think Cody wants his gimmick back.
And oh no. Rex, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God!
Oh God! It didn't break!
Good Lord in heaven! Oh, Rex isn't finished yet.
It looked like the back of his head hit that briefcase and the table didn't break. Oh God, what is that? What's good?
Oh no, no, no,
oh,
Rex.
God.
Not on
the floor! Gordon's out. We need help for him right now. Somehow he's moving. I don't know how.
Will he stay down?
Rex Titus though with that steel chair.
Oh!
All across the head.
Rex, enough!
Now what?
What has happened to Rex Titus? He did not used to be this way, V-Pac. He used to be a proud champion here. Ever since he got on a losing streak, he's changed his attitude. He's become vicious.
Well, that'll do it to you.
Almost like he's become AWOL. Oh God. Is this what's become of Rex Titus? Attacking people in the back like some sort of thug. Wait, Tony Gordon!
Oh, this Tony Gordon trying to fight back here.
Tony Gordon. Oh God!
Well, he's met with a vicious clothesline.
Rex, I don't think he's finished yet. Oh! Slamming his head back against that television set. Rex. Oh, no, no, no! Oh, God!
God! God! Now we definitely need help for Gordon.
Somebody get security back there. Somebody get EMTs back there.
It's time to strap our boots on. This is a perfect day to die. Wipe the blood out of our eyes. In this life.
Well, a vicious attack from Rex Titus. With V-Pac, it's time for our first and best of five.
Bowling contest, the first in the best of five number one contender match. Introducing first, from Indianapolis, Indiana, weighing in at 237 pounds, Matt Farrow!
Matt Farrow earlier tonight mentioned some of the people who have helped build TPGW as a brand. The likes of Rex Titus, the likes of Duncan Vermeil, the likes of Kevin Cash, and the likes of the man who will face the world champion at Crossroads in September, CJ Hawkins, who will be returning, as you saw in that promo earlier. But tonight, Matt Farrow seeks to earn a spot as a number one contender for the Euro-American Championship in a best of five. He asked to go through the most dangerous man out of Japan in order to do it.
And his opponent from Osaka, Japan, weighing in at 229 pounds.
Uh-oh. Wait.
He is the most dangerous man out of Japan, Andrew Tanaka!
Matt Farrow, I don't think he wants to wait for this match to start. Let's not forget he's still fuming over Malik Brown, over what Malik Brown did.
That's right.
Uh-oh, Tanaka wary about getting in that ring now. But wait, look at this, Tanaka! I think he's ready to get this started too. It's Tanaka.
Hey, here we go!
Tanaka! Oh! Oh!
Matt Farrow countering whatever that would have been to a clothesline.
He was looking for a package pile driver or something. But nonetheless, Matt Farrow, look at these stomps, V-Pac.
Matt Farrow, look at, he's not even letting Tanaka get his jacket off.
And Tanaka, I think he's looking to fight back as well. The most dangerous man out of Japan. Uh-oh.
Both these guys want that Euro-American title.
Euro-American championship shot.
Okay.
I've just been informed that the winner of this will face whoever the Euro-American champion is on the Fury after Eastern Invasion. And if this actually goes to five, the fifth match will take place at Eastern Invasion, V-Pac.
Well, there you have it. Look at this. Matt Farrow taking it to Andrew Tanaka. You know, he's probably not seeing Tanaka in the ring right now. He's probably seeing Malik Brown.
That's right. Matt Farrow. Absolutely.
Let's not forget what he said earlier tonight.
Which part?
Everything.
The part about being able to kick Josh Gunner's ass, or the part about Smokey's quote-unquote hillbilly love. I have never heard Matt Farrow stick his foot in his mouth more than ever.
I mean, does he not know how much of a rampage Smokey and the rest of the New Industry Standard have been go on in DCA?
Does he not know the kind of thing Smokey's probably going to do to him for saying that stuff about Trish?
Yeah, and considering I personally trained Trish.
Nonetheless, these fans seem to be on the hardcore King of Kings side here as they're cheering him on.
Well, I will admit that. Now, Farrow on the top rope. Moonsault connects. And only a two count from former Hartford champion.
Let's not forget, we are in Cincinnati tonight, which is very close to the hometown of Matt Farrow, Indianapolis. No, V-Pac. Matt Farrow.
Oh, Tanaka's in a lot of trouble right now.
I think Farrow's got to fly.
Matt Farrow off the ropes. Holy high hell.
And like the god Horus leaping into the air and coming crashing down on the air, onto Tanaka. See the reference I put there?
Yes, I did, and I actually appreciate that. I'm actually a big fan of Egyptian mythology. Oh!
Yeah.
And Matt Farrow with the huge forearm.
And now, let's see if I can...
Oh!
Look at that. Fireman's carry there by Tanaka.
Tanaka trying to fight his way back into this. Look at these elbows in the corner. The most dangerous man out of Japan, a master of strong style. Oh!
Yeah, what a very brutal style that is.
Indeed.
What a brutal style that is.
Indeed. Learning from some of the masters in Japan, like Tatsuki Fujinami. And Shinsuke Nakamura. Andrew Tanaka taking pages out of all their playbooks. And Tanaka! Oh! Springboard frog splash. That actually out of the page of Eddie Guerrero. Whoa, 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 whoa! Tanaka looked for the curb stomp. Tanaka looked for the curb stomp, and Matt Farrow carried him with a cutter.
Out of nowhere.
And Farrow. I think he's got Tanaka on the ropes. Whoa!
Right now he needs to be a rabid dog in that ring. He needs to go on there and
holy high hell!
Do something like that!
Super kick central from Matt Farrow! He picked him up and super kicked him in midair!
Yeah, he got so high, I think Tanaka was able to see Ra the sun god. And this one's over!
Farrow picking up the first win in a best of five in dominating fashion.
And you gotta wonder if Malik Brown and the rest of the new industry standard were watching that performance, because that very well could be their future.
That could be the fate of Malik Brown and Call All Stars 9. Matt Farrow could not only defeat Malik Brown, but could technically, when you think about it, become the DCA Celestial Champion.
That is important, and Malik Brown will still be Celestial Champion by then.
Okay, Matt Farrow wouldn't care about that. He wants Malik Brown in a fight. He wants to end him. He wants to take Malik Brown's legacy and tear it to pieces. And if he fights like he did here against Malik Brown, like he did against Tanaka here tonight, I don't see much of a future, with all due respect, for the mayor of the Violence Party.
I gotta agree with you on that one.
Matt Farrow on the warpath. And Tanaka suffering the wrath of a hardcore King of Kings tonight. Here is your winner, Matt Farrow!
So Farrow takes the lead in his best of five series, 1-0.
Oh no. Matt Farrow still got that angered look in his eye. Come on, Matt.
Farrow, enough is enough. That's not Malik Brown.
Matt Farrow
decided. I guess he realized
Yeah, Matt Ferry.
Definitely going to be interesting.
Brian Mayhem and Born the Pharaoh to take on Soul Reaper next. Matt Pharaoh, I guess, sparing Andrew Tanaka.
I think Pharaoh realized that that was not Malik Brown that he was fighting right there.
I just got word from the referee who was just checking on Tanaka. Matt Pharaoh said to him, I'll see you next time.
Calling contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, representing Nora Farrah from Belmont, England, weighing in at 348 pounds, the lunatic, Brian Mayhem!
There you see the lunatic.
Oh, yeah, here comes one half of Nora Farrah!
That's true. Nora Farrah, two-time tag team champions in TPGW, multiple-time tag team champions in other promotions. Matter of fact, Brian Mayhem himself is a former GCW world champion and is in their Hall of Fame.
Yeah, well, right now he's going to be going one-on-one with one of the weirdest individuals in TPGW.
The hardcore champion.
Also happens to be the hardcore champion.
And the leader of the Twisted Abyss, Soul Reaper. There he is, V-Pac.
Yeah, I see him.
And his opponent from the Twisted Abyss, weighing in at 236 pounds, he is the TPGW Hardcore Champion, Sound V-Pac.
There he is, the man who, I want to say retained the hardcore title, but really was handed to him.
Exactly. I still think Tony Gordon dropped this guy on his head too many times as a baby. Hopefully, maybe we're going to see how he does against one half of Nora Farrah and Brian Mayhem.
You enjoy that too much, don't you?
Hey, if you can do Neckbreaker, I'm going to do Nora Farrah.
Fair enough. And here we go.
Look at the size. We both these guys.
Mayhem, a former world champion in GCW.
Of course, Nora and Farrah have not been on the same page recently. I think that's what Brian Mayhem wants the singles match here tonight. Now is this for the hardcore title or not?
This is not, but if Mayhem can beat Reaper tonight, he may get one. And off the ropes. Oh, with a boot. And Mayhem choking him right now.
Obviously taking his frustrations over losing the tag team titles on Soul Reaper.
And Reaper not appreciative of it at all with that shot to the gut. And look at Reaper now.
Oh, look at this. Look.
Oh!
That was impressive.
Oh, come
God,
on.
That's arrogance.
Personality
the suplex was impressive, but that pinfall was full of arrogance.
And there's the power slam from Soul Reaper. Now going up to the top rope.
Oh, what is this?
No!
Oh, nice back elbow off the top there by Soul Reaper. But there you see. There you go. Brian Mayhem trying to fight back here.
Irish whip.
And conspicuous by his absence is Shaman.
Indeed. Like you said, Shaman and Mayhem haven't exactly been seeing eye to eye as of late.
Maybe they're... Oh, look at that. Powerbomb into a jackknife cover.
From what I understand, Morta Farah is still intact as a tag team. They're just settling their differences apart from each other right now. It's like being still being married, but technically being separated in order to just have some space from each other. Which is the most sane way I can think to explain it when it comes to Morta Farah. But look at this, Reaper! Reaper! The unholy driver as he goes for the pin. One! And no.
One count there by Soul Reaper.
Reaper, uh-oh.
As you mentioned before, Soul Reaper pretty much had the hardcore title handed to him by Malik Brown at Hawaiian Beach Bash.
Now look at this, a tremendous back and forth action between Reaper and Mayhem as Mayhem goes for the power slam and he hits it.
Nice power slam there by Brian Mayhem. Now what's he gonna do here?
Oh!
It looked like he was gonna go for some kind of cutter, but Soul Reaper saw it coming and now the hardcore champions on the top rope.
And Reaper, oh!
That totally deserves a cartoon sound effect.
Reaper misjudging the distance and Mayhem taking advantage of the spine buster. That's
huge
unlike
spine buster right there, and only a one count.
That's unlike Reaper to be that misjudging when it comes to distance like that.
And now,
Reaper, oh! Huge scoop power slam. And Soul Reaper, I think he's looking to send Mayhem to the Twisted Abyss.
Oh! Instead, standing dropkick there.
And Mayhem with the counter. And Brian Mayhem is looking to end it.
Oh, please end it. Please end it and put this
Oblivion Bomb! The Oblivion Bomb!
That could do it.
One!
Oh my god.
Reaper drawing on the dark powers of the Twisted Abyss to kick out at one.
Just how powerful is this Twisted Abyss?
What I understand, it's where Donald Trump gets his sanity from.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, it's that dark and twisted.
Maybe Tommy Ventura visited there recently. Maybe that's why he's acting the way he's acting.
Uh-oh.
Well, in case back to this matchup, Brian Mayhem with Soul Reaper and hitting the most overused move in virtual wrestling, the Superplex.
Mayhem just trying to punish Reaper, just trying to put him down. Mayhem now with the cover. And no.
Again. Again, Soul Reaper manages to kick out before a one count.
And Reaper, good lord. Measuring Mayhem. Oh, what a backbreaker!
I gotta admit, Soul Reaper's definitely been hanging in there with Brian Mayhem.
Oh, what a quick moonsault!
This time he got it. One, two, no!
Reaper with a stop. No! Mayhem moved out of the way of the Lion Salt. Reaper, DDT!
Big DDT there by Soul Reaper. And now Mayhem. Oh, wait. What is this?
Unholy Grace!
Oh, I get it. I get why it's called Unholy Grace.
No, no.
Oh, he could be going for it.
Reaper! Scythe connecting!
The scythe!
One!
He may be one of the weirdest people on the roster, MTB, but he just made a statement by defeating Brian Mayhem.
Nonetheless, Soul Reaper.
We take a look at some of the action from this match.
The Reaper, he hit the scythe, V-Pac. Decapitating and obliterating Brian Mayhem here tonight on Fury.
Yeah, that was impressive. I can't believe he knocked off a guy the size
Here's
of Brian Mayhem.
Soul Reaper successful here tonight. I'm showing these fans that he doesn't need Malik Brown to win a match. Uh-oh, did he hear me?
Oh, now what?
I think he heard me. Please do not come up here.
Oh, come on, what the hell is he doing now?
Oh no, I can't tell you what, oh no.
Oh, come on. Grim Reaper, enough. The match is over. You won.
Oh, no. Reaper, what are you doing? Soul Reaper, uh-oh. V-Pac, this looks bad.
This does look bad. Oh, come on. Kicking a man while he's down.
Brian Mayhem's in trouble. And Reaper's got that chair. Reaper's got that chair. Oh, God.
Oh, no, oh, no. He's going to pulverize his leg. He's going to pulverize his leg.
Oh, God. Move, Mayhem. Move. Oh, no.
Oh, God. I think he may have hit the wrong leg, though.
Good. Oh, my Lord.
It's a good thing he did not hit the leg with the chair.
I don't think he's done yet, though. Oh!
God, now he's using the chair to hit the legs. And what I want to know is, where the hell is Shaman?
Shaman isn't here tonight.
I mean, that's an unlucky break for Brian Mayhem.
And Reaper, I don't think he's done yet. I think he's trying to figure out what to do next. Oh, God. Reaper. Oh, come on!
Oh, no, not the neck.
He's got
the neck.
He's got that neck wrapped in the chair. Reaper, don't do this! Oh, God! Oh!
Oh, my God. We need some help out here for Brian Mayhem.
Oh, come on!
Oh, not again. Not again!
Reaper, stop this! Oh, God!
What the hell is Reaper trying to do here?
He's trying to end Brian Mayhem. No!
Seriously, what the hell did Brian Mayhem ever do to Shaman? I mean, what the hell did Brian Mayhem do to the Soul Reaper? You get what I mean.
I get what you mean there, V-Pac. Reaper, he's still got that demented look in his eye. He's trying to sacrifice Mayhem to the Twisted Abyss or something. Oh, God.
Now setting him over the top rope. Come on.
This is ridiculous. Reaper, he's got something sick and twisted in his mind now. He's tearing apart the announce table.
Right in front of us.
Brian Mayhem's in trouble. Oh, no. And Mayhem. Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. No. Reaper. Oh, no!
Oh!
Jesus! Brian Mayhem has been sacrificed to the Twisted Abyss. Invasion will be Sunday, August 6th. Hopefully Brian Mayhem's alright, V-Pac.
Yeah, hopefully he will be.
And hopefully Tony Gordon will be okay to compete here in our main event. It's main event time on Monday Night Fury. Rex Titus and George Alpine team up to take on the world champion Daniel Stone and possibly Tony Gordon. I hope Daniel Stone, if it's not Tony Gordon, he was able to find a partner. We'll find out. It's main event time. Next! And here comes the man calling himself a nightmare to America.
From this guy.
I used to as well. Ever since he quote unquote dipped his headband in the blood of his enemies, the Diet Red, Rex Titus is a changed man. He calls himself a nightmare to America and a nightmare to Daniel Stone's world title reign.
And he could be.
After what he did to Tony Gordon, I don't doubt it.
And speaking of Tony Gordon, is he even going to be able to compete in this match?
I hope so, and if not, I hope Daniel Stone found himself a partner. Otherwise, we may have ourselves a handicap match. And against the former world champion, that's not something you want. And his partner from Detroit, Michigan, weighing in at 235 pounds, the mixed martial arts general, George Alpine! V-Pac, you know George Alpine pretty well. You know he'll take any advantage he can. Especially if it's a two-on-one situation.
Exactly.
Both George Alpine and
George Alpine lost the world title to Daniel Stone not too long ago.
Indeed.
Here's a few back during Olympics.
Unable to recapture it in that fatal four-way too. So Georgie, be looking to correct that tonight.
Tonight he's teaming with Rex Titus, the man who will challenge.
Whoa, hang on, V-Pac. I just got word. Daniel Stone, George Alpine will be getting his one-on-one rematch for the world title next week on Fury.
Oh, wow. So an Olympus rematch next week on Fury?
That's right. That's going to be one hell of a main event, but it's all about the main event tonight. Fans on their feet for what Zahaya calls the heart of America. And their opponents, first from Washington, D.C., weighing in at 251 pounds, he is the TPGW World Champion, the All-American Outlaw, Daniel Stone!
Yeah. We'd like to make fun of Zahaya a lot here on commentary, but I will admit, he definitely came up with a nice nickname for this tonight.
Indeed, the All-American Outlaw, the American Suplex Machine, and the heart of America, the world champion, Daniel Stone.
Now the question is he going to go alone, or does he find a partner? Is Tony Gordon competing in this match? What's going on here?
I don't know. I hope Daniel Stone was able to find some. Holy shit!
What the hell just happened?
Mel Rian's back!
Who the hell is this guy?
The former world champion! The man that George Elwood took out of the apocalypse!
And his partner from Sacramento, California, weighing in at 231 pounds. Please welcome back the flashy one.
American Outlaw. Oh my.
Damn, you nearly gave me a heart attack, MTB.
It's so awesome to see Mel Rian back as this contest gets underway, and Daniel Stone, whoa!
I don't even know who this Mel Rian guy is.
He's a former TPGW world champion. After the hiatus came back, he was the guy who first won the world title.
Okay, so where has he been this whole time?
George, at Apocalypse back in April, I'm sorry, back in May, George Alpine injured him inside Hell in a Cell when George Alpine took the world title from him. Gave Mel Rian a concussion. Mel Rian's been out for a couple of months, and now he's back. Possibly looking for some payback against Alpine.
Well, in that case, that explains why George Alpine looked like he was freaking out when this guy came out of the ring.
And Daniel Stone getting some revenge for Tony Gordon here.
Yeah, well, in a sense, what turned out to be a game plan for Titus and Alpine turned out to blow up in their face. Here's the cover, two and no.
now the world champion, going to work on the man. He will defend that title against that. It's an Eastern Invasion he's defending the title against.
That's right. If Daniel Stone
Eastern
will
invasion.
Be Rex Titus is the number one contender at Eastern Invasion, but if that all depends on whether or not Stone can beat Alpine next week.
Oh, look at this now. He could be going for capital punishment.
No, wait a minute.
Or not.
Uncle Slam to Rex Titus. Daniel Stone is relentless tonight.
Slam. One, two, and no.
George Alpine breaking it up. It looks like Daniel Stone's going to give him some Germans for his trouble.
One. Two.
Ooh.
And three.
Uh-oh, but looks like Rex Titus is looking to take advantage.
Exactly, and now Titus. All the way slam onto the world champion.
Daniel Stone, reversal.
Nice counter there by Daniel Stone.
No!
And a running kick. Running boot to the face there by the world champion, and I think. Oh, I thought it was going to make the tag the ball riot over there.
Malrian.
I want to call him Orion for some reason.
Well, that's what I called him when he first came in, but it turns out his name's Malrian. And look at this. Rex Titus looking for a suplex. No! You can't suplex the American suplex machine.
Where do they come up with these names?
Oh, you see how many suplexes he does in a match.
No, I'm out. First we got Malrian, we got Stray Meeks. Was there something in the water or something?
Uh-oh. Look at this, Daniel Stone.
Oh, wait, what's he got planned here?
Whoa!
Oh, my God! That was very impressive there.
Vintage Daniel Stone, the suplex from the apron, is the All-American Outlaw now.
German suplex there from Honor Rex Titus. There's another one. And a third one.
And Daniel Stone is fired up. Rex Titus is on the ropes, following up the triple Germans with a capture fisherman.
World champion got bled here.
The cover.
Over the cover. Two and no.
Rex Titus is one of the most resilient individuals I've ever seen. And it looks like whatever Daniel Stone tries on Rex, he can't put him away. That's not making Daniel Stone. But Daniel Stone. Come to think of it, I've never seen Daniel Stone pin Rex Titus. The super soldier tries to get back into this match. And there's a quick slam from Rex. Tag in the corner now.
George Alpine's in.
Uh-oh.
Oh, yeah, Alpine, though, taking advantage of the situation. Setting Stone in the corner.
Daniel Stone.
Though, fighting back.
Uh-oh. George Alpine quick to counter. The Japanese arm drag. George Alpine. Going for the pin. One, no. Not even a one count.
Not even one. That's just to show you how tough the world champion is. But if you ask me, he's got to make the tag to his partner right about now. Capture suplex there onto George Alpine.
And look at the look on Malrian's face. He wants Alpine.
Yeah, you can tell.
And Daniel Stone is happy to oblige.
And here comes Malrian.
Malrian! And look at the flurry!
That's right. Mallory and Gully after the man who took 2 months of his career away from him. Garcia on a concussion.
Mallory now. Oh, big back body drop. These fans on their feet for the flashing one, the former world champion.
So why is he called the flashing one?
He's very flashy in the ring.
Oh, look at this, the Alpine, some kind of submission hold on.
Mallory, also known as the Ladder Master, considering the fact that he made for a name for himself in ladder matches.
Ah, okay. I was about to say Ladder Master. Okay, all right, now that makes sense.
Indeed, Mallory has never lost a ladder match, but that's beside the point. Look at this moonsault from the top rope.
It connects on the Alpine.
Told you he was flashy.
And he may be flashy, but he's definitely full of vengeance here tonight.
Oh!
And a huge shot there to Rex Titus.
Mallory, and he wants Georgie Otto himself. Now the Irish whip. Mallory, and whoa! I think Alpine avoiding it right there, whatever he was looking for. Now Rian, to the gut, and a DDT!
And now he owes Jason Collins 5 cents.
Here's an interesting concept for you. Mallory and once was in a triple threat match for the European and United States Championships at Revolution 2.
And that's where the Euro, Continental title is formed?
The Euro-American? No, actually it was formed after. Oh God! Mel Bottom!
Mel Bottom on a George Alpine. And cover him.
He's not done yet, V-Pac. Look at the look in his eye.
Mallory looks like he's been waiting 2 months for this.
No! Oh!
Big DDT there. Onto the, and we got a bleeder! And his name is George Alpine.
Alpine busted open Mallory. He's not going to stop until George Alpine has a concussion.
So, tornado DDT there by Mallory. Yeah, exactly. Barrett, it was friggin' George Alpine who gave that concussion to him. And now,
Georgie says, oh,
Mallory sending George Alpine to the outside.
Mallory in now. Oh! Oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh!
Right into the ring post goes George Alpine.
Spinebuster!
Huge spinebuster there by Mallory.
Oh! Head first in the apron.
I was about to say the referee.
Oh God! Mallory just told the referee to shut the hell up. Mallory breaking the pin, breaking the count.
Of course, I think Mallory is letting his emotions get the better of him.
Look at George Alpine. Does he really have room to fight back right now? Oh God! Not another one. DDT!
So this guy's finisher is the Bell Bottom?
That's right.
Does he have a version of the People's Elbow?
He does not. Uh-oh, Mallory in! Mel Bottom again!
Mel Bottom and Alpine looks like he's bleeding like a stuffed pig. And look at that!
I think Jordan
has made the world champion.
And look at this, I think Rex Titus is just giving up.
Capital punishment. Here's the cover. Look at that, Rex Titus didn't even bother trying to break that up.
Rex Titus is storming off as George Alpine lays the bloody mess in the middle of the ring, courtesy of the man who we took out, Maurean. What a shocker here tonight, the return of the flashy one. George Alpine, I hope he's okay. He's got a world title match next week.
Exactly. As we take a look at some of the action from this matchup. Now is an impressive feat of strength right there for the world champion with that suplex.
Daniel Stone suplexing Rex Titus around like a rag doll. Not able to put him away though.
And now,
Daniel Stone tried and tried and tried to put Rex Titus away, but the quote-unquote nightmare of America wouldn't go down.
Yeah, it was right here after Maurean beat the holy hell out of George Alpine. It was Daniel Stone, capital punishment, Rex Titus' father, trying to break that one up.
Here are your winners, Maurean and Daniel Stone! Well, welcome back, Maurean, and good luck next week, Daniel Stone. World title main event next week on Fury. And see you guys Wednesday on Live on mtbDAhkk with V-Pac. And we'll see you then. Booyaka! Peace!